Good day, everybody. This will be computer class tutorial on the software called DIPS. So it's part of rock science. And in this tutorial, I'm going to explain how we can conduct kinematic analysis on Toppling. And we will start with just a new file. And if you don't know how to use DIPS, please watch my previous file. You will find the link in the description. And what I'm going to do, I will use already prepared files from the tutorials. I'm going to tutorials. And here I will select this one, tutorial 7, kinematic analysis on Toppling. So I'm going to open this file. You will see there is lots of data here. And some of the analysis here we don't need. I'll just remove that. So. We don't need so these limits. In this tutorial, I'm just going to explain how to use software. There is not going to be much about theory. I think for the theory, I'm going to make another file, another video. So in this case, I'm just going to explain how we can conduct kinematic analysis, a step-by-step procedure. And what I would like to do first, I'm going to go to here, analysis. And you will see here, kinematic analysis. And display kinematic analysis. I'll just untick this box and click OK. So what I'm going to do next, I'm just remove all this. Just go to plain view. And this is something that we're going to have from site investigation of, I believe there is about 300 points. So these are poles of discontinuities. And these are results of site investigation already plotted. And what we would like to do is, so this is the data that we actually borrowed from the file. It's already plotted. And I'm going to just look at the graph. I don't need this. And so for this particular case, we have done analysis. And this is road slope, so it's cut. And while doing analysis, we also estimated that the slope face, so it was cut, that rock mass. And the slope face had the orientation of 45 deep. And the deep direction was 135. So these numbers will be also in the description of this video. You can find it later. And also when we did some investigation of the joints, the friction angle between the dominant type of joints was about 35 degrees. And what we need to do is just, we need to see if this particular rock mass can potentially topple over time, right? And this is the kind of analysis that we're going to do. First, I will do it sort of manually, step by step. And then I'm going to show you a shortcut how to do it quickly within just a few seconds. So let's start with the sort of a long way to do it. And first, we're going to draw a plane that will describe the slope face. And as we said, it's 45 over 135. So that's, I'm going to go to planes, add plane, just click any place in the center of the circle. And I'm going to label it as slope angle. And then I will put here 45. So that's deep, that was given to us. And 135. So make sure when you do this exercise, you have here deep in deep directions. You don't have anything else. Sometimes you can have trend over plunge. So make sure that's deep in deep direction. Okay. So this is a plane that represents the face of the slope cut. So next step is we're going to draw a plane, which we're going to call slip limit. And the way to draw this plane, there is a rule for that. So the deep direction is going to be the same, but the deep will be different. So deep will be slope angle minus friction angle. So the tip of the slope is 45. So if we subtract the dominant friction of the joints, it will be 35. So 45 minus 35 will give us 10. And this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna draw this plane. Again, just go to planes, add plane, click any place inside the circle. And this will be, we're gonna call it slip limit. Slip limit. And give direction, it's the same. It's 135, but the dip will be 10. So now you see we have a second plane, and what it shows is that it defines those discontinuities. They have a very high dip, so they're inclined at very high angle. So this is going to be the area here, and these discontinuities will actually contribute to toppling. So not other discontinuities inside here, all these poles, they are not going to contribute to toppling. So only this one, because that will be the inclination. It will be along the deep direction of the slope cut. And also it will be higher than the friction between these planes. Okay, so let's move. And now we're going to define the second condition of toppling, is that these planes should be within limits towards the deep direction of the slope. And the limits defined by Goodman, it's plus minus 30 degrees. So we're going to draw a cone, and that cone will give us the limits. So we actually need to define what poles among these will be actually critical. So to draw that, we're going to tools, we're going to find cone and orientation. So the rule is for trend is going to be deep direction plus 90 degrees. So deep direction is 135 plus 90 will give us 225. And the plunge is going to be zero. And the limits will be plus minus 30 degrees. So it should be, this plane should be more or less parallel to the slope face. So plus minus 30 will give us 60. So I click this button. So this is the cone I just drew. So that will define the area. So this is going to be the area. So this is the area of show discontinuities. So these are the poles of those discontinuity planes that will actually can topple at some point, right? So typically we're going to look at the percentage of these poles compared to the total number. And I believe total number was about 300. So what we can do, we can just count and divide by the total number. That will give us percentage. So everything that more than 6% will be susceptible to toppling. So I think it's very time-consuming procedure to count these poles defined by this area and also divide by the total. So I'm going to show you a shortcut. So how what we can do it. This software makes it pretty easy. We're going to analysis. We click kinematic analysis. Display kinematic analysis, and now we can choose any of the analysis that we're going to do, and we're going to do toppling. And what we need to provide is slope deep direction is 135, slope deep 45 is already here. Friction angle, I believe the friction angle was not 30, it was 35. And the lateral limits is plus minus 30. We'll click OK. Boom, you see, so it takes only 5 seconds and the analysis is already done. So this is the area highlighted in red. So this is critical zone for flexural toppling. So it was already part of the tutorial. So that's how we get this area. And what we can do now, we're going to look how many critical points inside this area, and the software already give us the answer 20. Total number it's 303. The percentage 6.6. So if it's more than 6%, it's already a red flag, so it's a concern. So we probably have to do more thorough investigation and see if it's that's rock mass can actually result in toppling. So that's it for this tutorial. I'm gonna finish right now. Thanks for watching. Hopefully you now know how to do kinematic analysis, step-by-step procedure, and how to use this button analysis, kinematic analysis. Bye, everybody.